Hey, what is up, Nation? In this session, I'm going to be teaching you how to make engraved or embedded text in SketchUp. All right, so I've opened SketchUp 2018 here, and I've pre-modeled this tombstone, or this gravestone. What we're going to do is we're going to put some text on it like you would see if you were walking through the graveyard. So the first thing that you want to make sure is that you have this toolbar. If you don't, you just want to right click in some open area, like here is good or down here. So just right click and make sure that you have large tool set checked. And it may bring up a window over to the side, and you can just drag and drop that in the side to dock it. But once you have that, you can come down to where this little icon is where it says 3D text. You just want to click that. Now in here, you can select the font, you can pick whatever you want. I'm just going to stick with Allegro Sans. You can choose if there's like bold or italics options for that text, you can choose that as well. Line, I'm going to stick with center for this. Form, filled, if you uncheck filled, then it'll just be the outline of the text. For this, I'm going to keep the text filled just to make sure that I do get the geometries that I want. And then if you just wanted to start with this being extruded, this is probably better for adding on, or if you're going to subtract the geometry, then you might want to choose extruded, and then you'd have this option here for the extrusion length, and then the height is the height of the text that you'll be doing. That's the X height, so a letter X will be 10 inches tall. A capital letter X, that is. So I'm going to put John Hancock in here, and he was born 1737 to 1793. Okay, we're just gonna do something like that, maybe give some spaces on the end. Okay, and it's gonna give me this text and I can place it. So if you know ahead of time where you want to place it, that'd be fine. Now what happens here, and I'm just going to reverse this just for my own sake. Control A to select all, right click, go to reverse faces, that way it's white. Now what's happening here is that once you do that, you're sort of done. You can't come back and edit the text, you just have to make new text. But what I want to do here is actually explode that so it's a part of this geometry. It looks like for some reason it may not have been directly on. So I'm just going to move this off, right? Then select this, holding the shift key, and make sure that it goes all the way down, right? And then select these guys. Are these voids? Yes, they are. So I just want to draw these geometries. It did some weird things. I just want to make sure those fill. Depending on the complexity of your font, you may or may not need to do that. And then I'm going to push this in. Let's choose 1 inch. How about that? And then you can just, you want to make sure you go this way. 1 inch. For some reason, it's not letting me double click. There we go. Then you can just double click on each one. Now this is a pretty deep relief, I think that's what they call it. You may or may not want to go this deep, but it gives a cool sort of effect. And then if I want to turn this to stone, let's try to find a material. Stone. There you go. So, yeah, hopefully this helped. If you like this video, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video with your friends. And as always, happy hacking.
All right, designers, just because this episode of Designer Hacks is over doesn't mean we're leaving you out in the cold. Tony's got tons of great content available at designerhacks.com. So join Design Nation right now, and we'll see you on the next episode of Designer Hacks.